last couple of months here. One of the real great parts of being with an organization is when an organization communicates better. When everybody has a vision, they believe in something. That's team sport. That's team play. We pick out a target, we're running toward it together. I trust Scott, I trust his staff. I have nothing personally against him other than it is excellent for me. But for me, at this time, with this team and this staff, I thought Scott's service was the best.
As a team, as an organization, to get our players in front of them, to allow you to get to know the personalities and the quirks of the manager and the staff, the individuals on the team. That's going to be something we focus on. Hopefully, more events like these, just being part of the community around us, is very natural. We teach it at the minor league levels. It's something that our kids, through the courses of structural league every year, you learn how to win a pickup of ground ball, how to throw a slider. One of the things we do with our young people in the minor leagues is we send them out to interact with the community 2 days a week. Wednesday, instead of going through the curriculum of how to command the strike zone, which we'll make on, we'll send them to a soup kitchen and they serve soup. They learn how to interact with the community, and the goal there being that when they get to Seattle, they just know how to become part of the community. As it pertains to Scott and his job here as a manager, I've known Scott for 25 years. Whether I've tied myself to him or not, if I did, I like that. I trust him, I trust his baseball acumen, and I said this before about Scott. He was the best farm director I ever watched. He knows how to connect and develop young players. He's as good a motivator as anybody I've seen. As a baseball fan, his acumen, whether this is right or wrong, I don't know. But when I think it's time to bunt, when I think it's time to hit and run, when I think it's time to remove the lefty and bring in the righty, Scott's usually thinking it just before I get there. That to me gives me a great deal of comfort that when I went out and bought the groceries, it gives me a couple of
right. We're going to have some autographs after, okay? Don't get too close to that bag. Just check. All right, I'll hear you.
Just getting off the field of batting practice for Anaheim, and draft was going on, ran in, and they just finished pick number 17, so I actually got to watch him get drafted in the clubhouse in Anaheim. So that was, that was a thrill. I had goosebumps and chills. I can't imagine he was going through it. But, it was, I got to speak with him real shortly after that. Justin, I was actually here, so we were at home, and I was sitting in the eat breakfast, actually. And that was another thing, just unbelievable thrill. It's awesome being in the same organization as Justin, getting to, share all these same experiences. He's playing in the same places, so it's been a blast. So thank you. I think it just got a little out of hand. I don't know. I could be a little annoying. I get that. Where I call timeout, I take my time in there, so I get it. But that was just something that got a little escalated quickly. I'm sorry.
Sorry for the late. It takes a
little bit. We could do that. Don't worry.
No, I couldn't read it.
Kyle, how does it feel like to be the best baseball player?